To better understand how conversions work, first we need to know some basic things about how the game calculates the numbers. Let's start from attribute points. Attribute points increase many stats including those that deal damage such as physical, pierce, etc. When we apply attribute points, we see some numbers as percentages. For instance, we can see here bonus to pierce damage plus 137.6%. This is a buff to our pierce dealing skills and attacks, and it is added to other percentages that we get to pierce type of damage from items, constellations, and passive skills. If, for example, we get plus 27% to pierce from an item, then we get overall 137.6 plus 287 equals 164.6%. Then this number increases the pierce damage of our attacks and skills that deal pierce damage. So, these multipliers work additively. Another thing to remember is that the game rounds up the numbers to the closer integer number, so if you have, for example, a damage number of 5.91192, then it will become 6. The game does not show any decimal numbers. The most important thing about conversions is to know what exactly gets converted. In this game we have two things that get converted: the base damage of our weapons, the base damage of our skills. Conversions never take into account any buffs that come from items, attribute points, constellations or skills. They always convert the base numbers of weapons and skills, and after the conversion has happened, then buffs to the converted type of damage apply and increase its numbers. Another thing is that we can only convert to a type of damage only once. For example, we convert a skill from physical damage to chaos damage. Now we cannot convert the chaos damage of the skill to another type of damage again. We can only remove this chaos conversion by removing the source that converts the damage type. Conversions formula of calculation on weapons with no extra flat types of damage. First, we multiply the weapon based damage with the number of the conversion. For example, when the number of conversion is 15%, we have weapon based damage times 0.15 and we get a number. Then we get the attribute points type of damage, which in this example is 23.5%, and we stack it, we add the multipliers that we get from other sources. So in this example we get 23.5% from attribute points plus 86% from other sources, and the number is 109.5%. Then we get the converted numbers and we add them to the stacked multipliers. Here we have 16.2 plus 109.5%, and we get a number which is the cold damage that we deal now. Conversions formula of calculation on weapons with extra flat types of damage. Again, in this case we take first the weapon based damage and we multiply it to the number of conversion, which in this example is 15%, so we get 32 up to 105 times 0.15, and we get the numbers that we see here. Then we add the extra flat damage number to converted numbers. For example, if flat number is 9, then 4.8 plus 9 is on equals 13.8. And for the maximum number, it is 15.75 plus 9 equals 24.75. Then the attribute points of damage plus the multipliers added together, in this case it is 23.5% plus 54 equals 77.5%. Then we get the converted numbers and we add the stacked multipliers. So, for example, we have 13.8 plus 77.5% equals 24.25, actually, because the game rounds up the numbers. And for the maximum number, 24.75 plus 77.5% equals 44. So vitality damage now is 25 to 44. Conversions have a cap which is 100%. If you equip items providing, for instance, 125% conversion to one type, then only 100% applies. The other 25% is useless. It is possible, though, to have more than 100% conversion of one type to two other types. For example, we have 100% conversion from Chaos to Aether, and also we have 25% Chaos to Vitality. In this case, both conversions happen, but they yield smaller numbers to fit the full amount of the damage type that gets converted. So, this is how the calculation works. 100% to Aether is divided by the sum 125 of both conversions. So, this equals to 0.8, which is 80%. 25% to Vitality is divided by the sum 125 of both conversions, which equals to 0.2, which is 20%. This means that now the conversion from Chaos to Aether is 80% instead of 100%, and the conversion from Chaos to Vitality is 20% instead of 25%. Dual wielding conversions. 1. If both weapons have conversion to the same type, the conversion stacks additively, then calculates the base weapon damage of both weapons separately, and the number after the conversion is added to the weapon attack of each weapon. So, if we get 15% physical to cold from these two weapons, then we convert 30% physical to cold from each one of the weapons, and the result is added as cold damage to each weapon separately. In the offhand damage here, we see bigger numbers because the base damage of the offhand is bigger than main hand's weapon, and of course because offhand has a bigger amount of frostburn damage. 2. If both weapons have conversion to different types. The conversions work on both main weapons and offhand's base damage, and they are calculated by the full amount of the base damage. Example. The main weapon provides 15% conversion from physical to cold. The offhand weapon provides 15% from physical to fire. The 15% to cold conversion works with the main weapons and offhand's base damage numbers, and results in cold damage 4 to 34 for the main weapon and 10 to 31 for the offhand. The 15% to fire conversion works with the main weapons and offhand's base damage numbers, and results in fire damage 5 to 35 for the main weapon and 10 to 33 for the offhand. Then, these numbers are added all together to the attacks of both our weapons, so the main weapon deals the numbers that we see here. Physical, fire, cold and frostburn, while the offhand deals the physical, fire, cold and burn. Frostburn applies only with the main weapon's attacks because it is provided by this item, while burn applies only from offhand attacks. The weapon damage that we see here is the numbers of each item, and the offhand has a bigger minimum number because the base damage is higher than the base damage of the main hand weapon, so the conversion of this item gives bigger numbers. Conversions work the same even with shields, but they only matter when we use skills that use shields to attack with. With no such skills, we cannot attack with shields, so conversions do not really matter. 1. As with items, conversions work only with the base damage of skills before any buffs from other skills or items are counted into the calculation. Let's see an example. The skill Ring of Steel initially deals 135 piercing damage. My character's Ring of Steel initial damage is 321 piercing. This number includes the bonus pierce damage that we get from Canic attribute, which is plus 137.6%. By putting 1 point in Ring of Frost modifier, we convert the full amount of pierce damage to cold damage. Now we see that the cold damage of the skill is a lower number than before. It is 269. This happens because the conversion affects only the base number of the skill, which is initially 135 pierce damage, and after this conversion, the buff from the spirit attribute applies, and the calculation is 135 plus 99.1% equals 268 point something, which rounds up to 269. 1A. Some skills do increase the base damage of skills, and they can give bigger numbers after the conversion. A. These are add-on skills to base skills. Example. We have used the modifier Discord to completely convert the physical base damage of Cadence skill to elemental. Now this skill deals 94 elemental damage. The Fighting Form skill is an add-on for Cadence, and if we put 1 point, we gain some stats including plus 12% physical damage. This buff increases the base physical damage of Cadence before conversion and any other buffs from other sources apply. And this is why, when we put more points into this, the elemental damage of Cadence increases. It increases because the conversion to elemental now happens to a higher base damage number, which came to be from this add-on. B. Aura skills. Skills that we activate once and they work constantly, like for example Mokdrogen's Path of Shaman Mastery. This skill provides a minimum and maximum number of physical damage. These numbers are added to the base minimum maximum damage of our weapons before the conversion happens, and then conversion yields even bigger numbers for the converted type of damage. In general, skills and devotion nodes that provide this type of minimum maximum damage work on the base weapon damage before the conversion applies. Also, when we convert to other types of damage, including elemental, then we convert not only the instant damage of those types, but we also convert the damage over time types. Example: Deadly Momentum. This skill triggers sometimes. It is not a constant effect, and when it triggers, it deals the types of damage that we see here. This skill initially applies internal trauma damage. This one is the damage over time type of physical damage. When we convert our Cadence skill to elemental, then when this skill triggers, all physical damage attacks turn to elemental, and this internal trauma over 2 seconds becomes actually elemental over 2 seconds. The same happens with all types of damage that have respective damage over time effects. Elemental conversion. We can also convert types of damage to elemental damage. When we do that, we convert the weapon's base damage to elemental, and we get all 3 elemental types added to our weapon attacks, and all elemental types deal 1/3 of the number that comes after the conversion. Example: we get 12% physical to elemental from this shield. Now the calculation is this: 34 weapons base damage times 0.12 equals 4.08. Now we add 284.7% from spirit bonus plus 50% modifier to elemental from the shield equals 334.7%. Now we do this: 4.08 plus 334.7% equals 17.7. This number is the elemental that we get after the conversion, but it gets divided by 3. So we get 17.7 divided by 3 equals 5.9, which rounds up to 6. So, the minimum damage that gets added to our weapon's attack after the conversion is 6 for each one of the 3 elemental types of damage. So, when we get flat numbers of elemental damage after conversions of skills and items, these numbers are getting divided by 3. For this type of conversion, the same general rules apply as for the other types. We calculate the numbers the same way. So, for example, if we equip the common Ternist Carver weapon, then our weapon's attack shows physical 13 to 36 and pierce 1 to 4. Now, if we equip the Amulet Lazarus Ruby, which provides 10% physical damage converted to fire, then our weapon's attack still shows 1 to 4 pierce damage, and this happens because, once again, pierce conversion happens on the full amount of the weapon's base damage. It doesn't come before or after conversions of other types happen. There is only a difference in calculation when we equip two weapons that provide pierce armor. As we said before, for other types of conversion, while dual wielding, if we get the same type from both weapons, then these two stack additively. For armor piercing though, this doesn't happen. When we equip two weapons with armor piercing on each one, then the conversion happens only for the respective weapon. It doesn't stack as with other types. Example: on main hand, we equip the sword that provides 10% armor piercing. We see that the pierce damage we gain from this conversion is 1 to 4. In the offhand, we equip an item that provides 21% armor piercing, and when we go to see the stats, we still see pierce 1 to 4. Should the conversion of the two items stack, we would have seen bigger pierce numbers here and not the same. When weapons have extra flat minimum maximum piercing damage, then if weapon base damage is 64 to 105 and we have 33% armor piercing, then we do 64 times 0.33 equals 21.12 and 105 times 0.33 equals 34.65. Then we multiply these results with bonus pierce damage from attributes and modifiers. So 21.12 plus 216.8% equals 66.9 and 34.65 plus 216.8% equals 109.7. After that, we take the extra flat piercing damage and multiply it with bonus pierce damage from attributes and modifiers. So 12 plus 216.8% equals 38.016 and 25 plus 216.8% equals 79.2. Then we add the results from 6 and 7 steps and we stack them together. So 66.9 plus 38.016 equals 105. And 109.7 plus 79.2 equals 189. When we have weapons providing armor piercing and at the same time we have a percentage of pierce conversion from other sources, then only the armor piercing converts a portion of the base damage of that weapon, and after that conversion, the percentage of pierce conversion will not work on the pierce damage that we get from armor piercing because conversions happen only once. If we get flat numbers of piercing damage on items and we have a percentage of pierce conversion, then first we add the flat numbers of damage together and then the pierce conversion happens on the sum of the piercing damage. This is also called lifesteal. When you get it on items, it works only with the weapon attack damage, meaning the attacks of our weapons. We can also find it in some skills, which means that when we use those skills, it works again. We can stack attack damage converted to health if we get it on many items, but when we get it on weapons, the lifesteal percentages on weapons do not stack with each other. They only stack with those from other items or skills that provide it to weapon attacks. Actually, there is only one skill from Masteries that provides lifesteal to weapon attacks, and that skill is the Harbinger of Souls skill of Necromancer Mastery. My lifesteal is 12%. I get 8% from this amulet and 4% from this node of Gaul Constellation. Looking at this stat, we see that both main and offhand weapons deal the same 12% lifesteal. None of my current weapons provide lifesteal. If I replace one of my weapons with another with lifesteal, we can see now that one is at 12% and the new one deals 17%. So, if we have two weapons with lifesteal equipped, the lifesteal of each weapon works only for that weapon, not for both. Also, shields are weapons too, and whatever said for dual wielding weapons applies also to shields. One last thing to remember is that lifesteal works only with direct attacks. It does not work with damage over time attacks such as bleeding, frostburn, etc.